thank you so much for this opportunity. I just wanted to read, there is a verse that he read early in the morning, and I just want him to finish it, like from 23 and then 24. Prayer for Ronald of himself.
Praise God. This is Colossians chapter 3 from verse number 23. It says, whatever you do, work at it with all your heart, as though you are working for the Lord and not for human beings. Remember that the Lord will give you as a reward what he has kept for his people. For Christ is the real master you serve. And wrongdoers will be repaid for the wrong things they do, because God judges everyone by the same standard.
Can you repeat only 24?
24 says, remember that the Lord will give you as a reward what he has kept for his people. For Christ is the real master you are serving.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Actually, when he read it in the morning, I just felt like, let me just finish it to see what's in there. Was at first what I was doing when I met the Bakanishi is that I always believe that each and every person that you meet is important because he is the image of God. It doesn't matter who, a small kid, president, whoever you meet. But now, what we are seeing there is that God has some reward for us. And I didn't know that he had a reward for me. I was just helping the baggage ministry. Anyway, in 2017, I met the baggage ministry as a driver. And the first surprise that I gave him is that I picked them at the airport. We went to Mayfield. We slept at around 12, that's midnight. And then even they didn't know how far are we going to get to Eldoret. So they were to fly in the morning. I organized with the Mayfield that I want you guys to pick these people and then take to the airport. At around 3 a.m., I think 1 a.m., I and my colleague, we were drivers. So we drove all the way to Eldoret at the middle of the night.
They had to leave early because the Americans brought too many suitcases, and we were going to fly the next day, but we brought so many that we couldn't get them on the plane. So these men had to drive and haul all of our bags, and they left at 1 a.m.
So actually, when they go to Eldoret, they were really shocked, like, we flew for an hour. How did you guys manage to reach here? So what I'm saying is that whenever you are being asked to do something, just do it with your own heart. Don't ever say like, that's none of my business, I don't want to touch that. Because it's not that person who sees you, it's God. God has a plan for you. And sometimes he gives you a test, like I want you to try this. This is a test for you guys. It's a test for you guys. So God is testing you, and I'm not sure if you'll pass the test, and if you don't, that means you didn't give all your heart. You are just like, I'm just doing. I remember I was asking myself, after like 1 year, 2 years, I was just driving them for a week, and that was it. I thought I'll never see them again. I didn't know, I didn't do it because I knew like they'll come back. I was just doing it like, I just want them to have the best moment of me. I never knew that they'll still be here. After like 4 years now, they are still here. So don't ever look at something and say, this is just a passing thing. Just to give your best. You promise that?
Yeah.
So each and every day, whenever I come together, I tell you guys, there is opportunities. Whenever this guy comes here, don't ever look at them as like, I don't want even to make friendship. Just make friendship. I always tell you that whenever you go back to your home, if your mom is suffering, like she doesn't have clean water, if your neighbor, if anyone, just take a picture of it. Take a picture of the situation. Each and every time you pass, just be concerned about someone. It's not your life. You know, God has given us an opportunity to make a change. And the opportunity is just to do it right away. Just to do it right now. Don't wait for another day. Don't ever wait. Don't ever wait for someone to do it. It's you. And every little thing that you do can bring a big difference in someone's life. It brings a big difference. You might see us like just a painter in a home. It will just bring a big difference. And whenever someone says, thank you so much, that's a blessing. That's a big blessing. So, I always tell Reverend Solomon, I don't want you to mention that I'm a director, because I just want to be that ordinary person doing extraordinary things. And I want you to be the same people. Just be an ordinary person doing extraordinary things. Because I know there is a plan. God has a blueprint for you. Ready. It's just you to step in. And you will be like, hey, I didn't know I'll get here. It's a surprise for my family. When our big man here told me that, hey, I need you to move to Nairobi. I did ask my wife that, kind of, we are moving to Nairobi. So that was just a wildest dream in her. Like, are you serious on doing your job? I insisted, it's real. She was like, no, that's not true. To a point, I bring that message and then show her that this is what the brother sent us. So this is it. And, you know, there is something that in your life you think that this will never happen. At some point, you feel like, yeah, I'm done. When I take you back, I was just a farmer. And I'm a farmer. I had that life, that not beautiful one. I had struggles. And I never gave up. I waited for the Lord. I never, ever gave up. And I want you to know that whenever you give up, there is a way that you do things. You will start drinking. You go on a drinking spree. You will start stealing someone's property. You will start being just a savage. That's when you know that you've given up. But keep waiting. And be blessed. So I know that there is a journey. Okay, what I believe in, life is a journey. So whenever you start your journey, it's kind of like we are on a journey now. So there is a point where you get stuck. You start your journey, then you get stuck at some point. This is the point where so many of us give up. By giving up, you just take the wrong direction. So if you take the wrong direction, you might fall over the cliff. That's the end of the day. If you take the wrong direction, you might get killed maybe because you are a thief. You might get diseases because you are loose. But if you keep waiting, there is someone that God sent. There is someone who is, you know, still coming to your direction. And if that person gets you there, your life will change. Your life will change. So I did my Form 4 in 2003, and I waited till 2017 when he came. I was really patient, right? So you too, you've been like, yeah, I don't have anything to do. I don't have a life anymore. But you've been waiting. And the bagelist came to Nairobi. The bagelist is here in Kibera. And this is your time. This is your time to change someone's life. Because I'm pretty sure 100% that your life has already changed. And the Lord more in store for you guys. This is just something small.